And this, and now another issue is besides the water withdrawal issue, you just have, as I mentioned earlier, these are rural communities, small farming communities. This is the disturbance that you're going to have to these communities. This is the number of truckloads that come with this. You'll see a total of 8,000 truckloads. These are semis, 16-wheel semis. Some semis coming into communities that sometimes don't have more than one semi, two semis coming through in a day to pick up loads or something. It's just obscene about the amount of truck traffic that are going to come through these areas. And as you can see, it's for each part of the process. They have to bring in all the equipment by trucks. There's no other infrastructure to bring it in. Get the next slide, please.
This is for construction of the pad.
Can you go back real quick?
When you're talking about the community disturbance and the number of truck trips, that's for purposes of drilling the pad, bringing the equipment, and that's for the initial construction.
Yeah, yes, there, this part here, the drill pad, the drilling rig, and the fluid and materials and the drilling equipment, and the completion of the rig, right there you get to just the bringing in and setting it up.
And how long time does this take?
I don't know exactly how long it takes over time, but they've done it really quickly. I know in some of the communities they've put in well pads within a matter of weeks. I don't have a precise answer for you, but I can get it to Connie, and I know she knows how to fight you. But yeah, and that's just up to the completion. Now you have the fracture. Once they have it completed, you have the fracture fluid that's coming in, and then you have the water and the sand, and then you have the flowback removal. So all the water just gets removed. You have 1,600, 2,400 additional tanker trips to remove it. So,
once that is done, is there any more of this for
that particular well location? Not anywhere near the intensity, but now there these wells are set up so that there's going to be a well here, and then on Joe's farm over there, there's going to be a well. On Mary's farm over here, there's going to be a well, and then another and another. There's estimates of areas that don't have any wells now going upwards, and there's conservative estimates that say 20,000 wells. There are a lot less conservative that say 50,000 wells. This Marcellus Shale is the natural gas play right now. That is the hottest area for natural gas. That is where everyone wants to drill. It has the most volume of natural recoverable natural gas right now in the United States. The gas comes right back up from the same well, and then they cap the well with a device that allows it to keep and hook it to the pipeline.
And then you need transmission.
And then you need to set up a whole infrastructure of pipeline transmission to go from each of the wells into a main pipeline. There's actually up there now is the Millennium Pipeline, which was built several years ago, which is set up now and will be getting all of these to feed into it. I can't recall. It's from 3 or 4 years ago. Yes. Do you have another question?
No. How many wells do you are projected?
In just in New York, I think 20 to 50,000 is the projection. 20,000. Yeah, 20,000 to 25,000 is the conservative side, and then it goes up. Some say 50,000. It's hard to really know because we look at other places in Wyoming and in Texas, and we try to project from that. But when you look at the size of the Marcellus Shale compared to the size of those other shales, they're much smaller. And in one place in Texas, there were 20,000 wells that went up. And that's a smaller place. That's where the conservative estimate comes from, I believe. That's just my theory on that.
Can you address the issue, who owns that gas? I mean, if they're drilling on Joe's farm and then they turn horizontal, how far can they go? Can they go onto Mary's farm and take the gas? How does that work?
In New York?
In New York? Or
well, it's that answer varies from state to state, depending on laws, on different laws. They've given get leases for the property. The gas companies lease the land from the people who live in the community, and based on the lease, then they then go in and then they drill, and the property owner get a percentage, a royalty payment. They get a lease payment and royalties from what's extracted.
Is it possible, for example, for the adjacent landowner to lease it, the land?
Yeah.
And say that you drill on Joe's land, but you can have some of the gas that's under my land.
Yeah, I can't remember the term for it, but if you get enough people in the area to sign leases, the person who doesn't matter. They can come. They can take it anyway. I don't remember the exact term, and if it comes to me, I'll let you know.
So if everyone says no, does that mean that they can't drill?
Well, they need a leasehold to be able to be on the property that they are actually drilling putting the well pad on. So yes, if everyone says no, if everyone in New York State says no, they won't do it. But you know, right now, if you guys turn on TV, you see the commercials all the time, gas, the clean energy, and all this, and also everyone sees, you know, the economy is depressed. These areas that we're talking about in the southern tier of New York are some of the most depressed economies in all of New York State. They are looking for anything to help them rebuild their communities, and they're being sold. Someone comes in and says, "Hey, you've got this great piece of property. I can quadruple your money right now on the property. I can give you money so that you can move to Florida for the rest of your life." And so, I mean, that's what's happening. So people are signing leases, and they're actually, several years back, people were signing leases at very low rates before they realized what was going on. But since then, there's been a lot of community outreach and activity, and some of it was in order to negotiate for higher lease rates, and some of it has been to stop it. So, but now there's been much more fair terms in the leasing agreements than there were before anyone knew what was going on.